Really, the big focus of this interview is going to be technical skills. Most interviewers are going to run a few warm-up questions, one main question that's going to take the bulk of the time. So you can imagine a 30 to 35 minute interactive question.
The questions themselves aren't going to have the answer presented to you directly. You really have to understand what the question is asking and have an understanding of different data structures and algorithms to be like, okay, I can mix and match this together a little bit to make this happen. And then you can build on top of anything you have to do inside the actual interview.
From my experience, all the interviewers from Google are extremely nice. So they are very supportive and helpful. Even though the first solution you come up with might not be the best, they will guide you through, give you enough hints. So eventually you can get the best solution. You definitely need to think out loud. First, ask clarification questions. Second, call out assumptions. Third, you need to explain your thoughts clearly before jumping into coding.
It's like, what are your edge cases? Define those first. Is anything gonna be no? What kind of inputs are you getting? So you can make sure that, you know, your system won't break halfway through. Definitely speak out loud so that your interviewer knows kind of where your mind is on certain things. And that's when they can give you like hints every now and again. Like, oh, maybe you don't use a hash set. A hash map might be a little better.
I think a lot of people come into it with the misconception that for every problem you're given, you must find the algorithmically optimal solution. But it's better to find some solution than none at all. That's really easy to mess up.
The biggest piece of advice of how to do well at a software engineering interview is to not try to do well at the interview, but how do you do well as a software engineer in general, right? And that comes with practice, that comes with knowing your code. So you really have to do what you have to do to make sure that when you do get on site, you crush it.
I'd recommend the Google Tech Dev Guide to make sure that your fundamentals are gonna be strong for the interview. Make sure you're really good at least one language, because you're only gonna get to pick one when you do the interview.
Prepare yourself, get used to code on a whiteboard. The difference coding on a whiteboard and coding on an editor is that you don't have any helpful tools to guide you through to finish the syntax.
So it's easy to just practice writing some code on a piece of paper or where you don't have that type of tool. I think there's a misconception that you need to be like the best engineer ever to work at Google. You know, you don't need to be an expert at algorithms. You just need to be good at them. You don't need to know some really high level complex data structures. You just need to know all the basic ones really well.
You kind of think of Google as this like super software engineer producing entity, but then you realize it's people that have also been through your same process, right? They practiced, they worked, they developed to be who they were today.
Of course, Google likes to hire smart people, but don't underestimate yourself. You can do it.